Good Erev Shabbos. We're going to start first with an incredible Torah from the Tashi Rebbe and Avodas Avodah. As we mentioned from the Zohar HaKadosh says that Korach, what was Korach's mistake? Obviously Korach was, there was something so deep. Korach was from Noisei Ha'oron. Korach obviously had revelations, says the Tashi Rebbe. Carrying the Oron wasn't just carrying the Oron carried you. When you were carrying the, what's called the Ark, that had the Luchos, it was carrying you. Carrying you means that there was revelations, there was insights, he was connected to the Rebbe Yisrael at some level. And the Zohar HaKadosh says that his intention was something very deep. He wanted to switch around the right and the left. What does that mean? He wanted to switch around on the right and the left. He wanted to switch around the Levim and the Kehanim. What does that mean, the Levim and the Kehanim? That means the following. The Rebbe Yisrael, when he created the world with what's called Din. And deep, then the Shiras and the root of Din is actually Chesed, because the Rebbe Yisrael was only kind. True Chesedim come through Dinim, but this world wasn't able to handle it. So Hashem was Meshatef, he joined Midas Harachamim. So instead of having Din, it was really a combination of Din and Chesed, which gives you Rachamim. What did Korach want to do? Korach wanted to bring it back now. He felt, and this is why the Tashi Rebbe says so beautifully. He says, look, Korach, first of all, when Korach complained, right in the beginning, it says, Vayikach Korach ben Kas ben Yisrael ben Levi. So Rashi says, he didn't want to mention Yaakov Avinu. Why Yaakov Davna? You shouldn't be mentioned. What about Levi? Why is Levi mentioned? Another kash is, the Midrash says, when Korach started, what Korach saw that he started up with Moshe Ben, he saw Parah Aduma. Ad kan divrei Midrash, this is the Midrash. What's the connection between Korach and the Parah Aduma? And again, like the Zohar Kodesh says, and then Rashi says also, the reason why Korach started up is because he said to Moshe Rabbeinu, we were all by Har Sinai. Yeah. So what? What's this Har Sinai? He mentions this twice. We were by Har Sinai. We all heard Anoichi Hashem Elokecha. Says the Tashi Rebbe, such a deep message, such a deep, beautiful pshat, and hopefully we can bring it down to us. He says, when it comes to this world, initially, it was supposed to be Midas Adin. Midas Adin is really Shevet Levi. That means that when, after Cheta Egel, when we lost this lofty level, we went back to what's called Midas Arachmim. And Midas Arachmim is really a Midas of a Kohen. A Kohen, the Arizal says the following. I know you're going to be shocked, and I don't want to disappoint the Kohanim, but listen to Levim very carefully. In this world, and when the Beis Hamikdash was around, and after Cheta of the Ego, Kohanim, which are Midas HaChesed, so they were the main personality in the Beis Hamikdash. They were doing the main Avodah, and the Levim was, so to speak, an escort. Levi actually means to escort someone. But, says the Arizal, when Mashiach comes, when Midas Adin is going to go back to being the Iker, because at that point we're going to be what's called Mamtik Dinim, it's going to be the best, it's going to be the ultimate Chesed. At that point, the Levi is going to be the main guy. He is going to be the main guy in the Beis Hamikdash, and the Kohen is going to be his Melav, as Zok to Ari HaKodesh. So that's already something that Levim, you can look forward to, and Kohanim, I'm sure you're still going to have a good time. I don't want to take it away. As Zok to Arizal. So what happened? Korach said that, wait a minute, he was from the Noisei Ha'oron. He was having revelations. He was feeling that, wait a minute, we're already going back. Meaning to say, even after Chet of the Ego, he felt that Kulana, we were all by Har Sinai, and we lost that level, and we should go back to that level. And that's why he wanted to switch the right and the left. Parah Aduma, so the Zohar Kaddish says, the Par is the gematria of the letters of Man Tsepach, Mem Nun, all the Ende Nuns, Ende Nun and Ende Mem. These are very Kabbalistic letters. Together they spell out Par. He is five, those five letters. Those are all representing Dinim, whatever that means on a Pi Kabbalah. And therefore, Korach, what did he see? He saw Par, he saw the Par Aduma, he thought it's now time to bring it back to the world of Dinim. That's why the Arizal says we're going to pass like B'Chamay, because B'Chamay is really sourced from Dinim. Beis Hillel, all the ones that make most. Every time we paskin, it's usually according to Bezalel. There's a few places we paskin like Beit Shammai. Why? Because there's a few places we still were already holding by the what's called the world of Din. This, says the Tashi Rebbe, is exactly our avodah. So, wait a minute. So we understand a little bit of Korach. At the end of the day, it all came from a negiah. Korach somehow was losing sight of where reality is, where Klal Yisrael are, his involvement and his desire to be someone different than what, like we said in the beginning of the week, than what he should be, that he wants to be now already is the position of the Levi of the future. That's what causes destruction. And we know that we have to work on ourselves. And one of the main things of working on ourselves is to make sure we're wanting, we desire what Hashem wants. And I'm going to tell you an incredible pshat. Bli Nedah is going to be ready on the next video because I don't want to make this video too long.